So you see why the world is so polarized. People who are against USA right now are not the people who are saying that war is correct. So don't you think that USA actually, because of creating a hegemony, has created a roadmap for the failure of another international organization? Don't you think another countries will say that why are there two different types of rules when it comes to similar crimes? Because if one president should be tried for war crimes, what about the war crimes of Iraq, Afghanistan, etc.? Different types of bombs. What is the difference between nuclear reactor and a nuclear bomb? Or atom bomb? What is the difference between a nuclear reactor and atomic bomb is basically controlling. This is a controlled reaction, and when it becomes an uncontrolled reaction, it acts like a bomb, which works for every kind of bomb. The bombs which I see in news are first cluster bombs. Cluster bombs. Now, one thing which Russia did was that it used a vacuum bomb. Now, is vacuum bomb a nuclear bomb? Is vacuum bomb a nuclear bomb? No. Vacuum bomb is not a nuclear bomb. Vacuum bomb is not even a cluster bomb. You have treaties, you have conventions which ask for sanctions against the nuclear bombs, but none of them are for thermobaric or vacuum bombs. So one thing which Russia said that you cannot put sanctions legally on me because there is no paperwork. But then can it be used as a ground for war against or crime against humanity according to the Hague Convention? How many of you have heard of this Hague Convention? Hague Convention. Acha, one more thing. The reason I throw these terms at you, knowing that many of you do not know about this, believe me, it is so that there is some familiarity. Because I know you will be listening to this in news and in news article, I want you to make a connection. It has nothing to do with making you feel, that you don't know this or there is some sort of panic. Are we clear on that? Wo cheez nahi aani chahiye dimag mein. That should not come to your mind. So Hague Convention actually is the convention which you have an International Court of Justice. You have an International Court of Justice. Right? And it says that Vladimir Putin should be actually tried as a culprit against the humanity. And why? From where did the very strong conversation started when he used a bomb called as vacuum bomb for his war crimes, as crime against humanity, etc. Alright? Now, the problem is, again, which was one country which has asked its Congress and Senate to pass a law in which the president cannot be tried in the International Court of Justice for war crimes is USA. And your very favorite George Bush was the president who actually signed it. And hence you cannot actually have proceedings against the US president. So you see why the world is so polarized. People who are against USA right now are not the people who are saying that war is correct. Do you understand this? Do not become, if you are not supporting one, you are supporting the other. So don't you think that USA actually, because of creating a hegemony, has created a roadmap for the failure of another international organization? Don't you think another countries will say that why are there two different types of rules when it comes to similar crimes? Because if one president should be tried for war crimes, what about the war crimes of Iraq, Afghanistan, etc.? Alright? So if you have to prepare the essay writing or answers or your mains answer writing, those who are not giving the prelims this year, keep these things, keep jotting these things down. It will help you a lot in those extra 2-3 marks. Chaliye, Coming to the bomb which has sanctions and which cannot be used, there are 110 countries in the world which have signed not to use cluster bombs, which does not include Russia, Ukraine or USA. USA and Russia generally don't sign such treaties. Ukraine has also not signed such treaty. But yes, there is a lot of criticism for Russia to use these bombs. Have you come across news that a bomb has been found, which is of Russia but did not explode? Suniye ye news. Ki ek missile mili hai. They have found a missile and it did not explode. It's simply lying there on the ground. Those are nothing but part of the cluster bombs. Yes. It is not necessary that it shall always explode, but it can explode at any point of time. So much so that these bombs were actually used during the wars earlier, and many of these missiles are still found in the World War II or the later stages where the wars were fought. So what exactly happens? Do not even go here. You have this kind of canister. What is a canister? Which has a lot of material inside, right? This canister can be mounted on an aircraft, and once it is released, it actually bombards multiple types of bomblets or small bombs. These are called bomblets, all right? And they are attached to these parachute like devices. These are attached to these parachute like devices, and they break into metal fragments upon detonation. Those metal fragments, shrapnels, which you see on soldiers, somebody loses an eye, you know, the shrapnels all over the body. This is when it is detonated. Many fail to go off immediately, but they can always be accidentally detonated and are always a risk for the citizens. Alright? So, the leading producers of cluster bombs are USA, Russia, China and Israel, and none of them have signed the pact. In fact, Ukraine also has not signed the pact. So please write the topic cluster bomb